sitting at floor, whether it is a band pass filter or band stop filter.
Sir, in League Lad or Lag Lead or whatever, it can be both. It's mainly band pass filter.
Mainly band pass. Can I restrict? So your slide, your presentation, you have done your band pass filter, looks like a band pass filter or not? Anyone can share? Whether it is a band pass filter? I want to see. You have to call a share, Gudu.
Sir, I'm going to share it, sir. Okay. Sir, I'm going to ask you, sir. Sir, it is correct.
No, no, no. I was going to say simple design to 500,
one. Yes, sir, it's there. Yes, sir, it's there. R1, R2, C1, C2, Bahala, empty graph. I mean, it's a magnitude part and it's a phase part.
So, it looks like a weak filter. Uncompensated means that is your red line, I think.
No, uncompensated is a blue line. Oh, it's a compensated red line.
Compensated means you want to show your MATLAB code?
Yes, sir. What
is it, PR? That is written?
Sir?
Your lag net compensating network. One is uncompensated,
yes.
One is uncompensated, you have taken.
GS is the, sir, GS is uncompensated one and GCS is compensated one.
No, actually GS is the transfer function that was given to you, I think so.
Yes, ma'am. GS is that transfer function.
Yes, open loop transfer function that was given to you, right?
Yes, ma'am.
GCS is the uncompensated open loop transfer function. Sorry, compensated open loop transfer function. Yes?
Yes, ma'am.
GCS we
found out and GS was given.
Yes.
Yes, ma'am.
You can go another process also. You can directly find out R1 up to value. You are given it C1, C2. And you can find out the value of R1 up to. After finding R1 up to, you can directly put the value in GCS. Your transfer function that was given to you in Lag-Lead compensation transfer function. And you can directly put that and you can find out the value on that. Instead of going by this process also, you can directly go for GCS.
Okay, ma'am. Directly, yes. The transfer function I'll write.
Yes. You first find out the R1 up to value. You are given with GPIM and as well as you are given with FM value for different FM value. Yes, sir.
Yes, ma'am.
Different C1 value is given. You have to find out tau 1 and tau 2, alpha and beta. Then after finding that, you can directly put the value in the Lag-Lead transfer function. That is the compensated one, GCS. Okay. In that you can directly put this value and find out the result, and you can take as norm as this value, DAN as this value, and GCS equal to transfer function norm DAN, that much. And whatever you are given with that, you can see it in the command window whether your calculated value is same as the technical value or not. You can find out within that. This is one process and that is also another process.
Yes, ma'am.
Because this process is a little bit lengthy and that process is very simple one. Because if people have not understood what is phase margin, gain margin, all that not understood in the control system. Because of that, sir has told the name, only GCS. Okay.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay.
Ma'am, can I present?
Yes, sir.
So, ma'am, whether is it correct?
Yes.
Okay, ma'am. Thank you, ma'am.
okay, Pradeep, you can share your screen. After Pradeep, we'll start the new experiment today itself, because it's already 10:30.
Ma'am, I got this type of output.
But see, can you please show me your MATLAB code?
Yes, ma'am.
You have taken the different transfer function, Pradeep. Same code, but you have taken the transfer different transfer function, right? But Suparna, you have taken the same transfer function that was given to you in the
yes, ma'am. Okay. In the class, whatever last class you have given,
but,
I have not the value.
I have given information through Pradeep that you will take another transfer function for that. So
ma'am, that is same.
Yes.
Ma'am, that is same in case of Pradeep and me, that GS is same, but that GCS is different.
How GCS will be different? Because that means your R1 R2 value will be different. You have taken different C1,
C2 value. Has taken different R1 R2 C1 C2. I have taken different.
No. R1 R2 value cannot be different because C1 C2 we have already provided. I think 0.1 microfarad and something 100 microfarad like that. We have given
that. One was 0.1 microfarad,
yes,
another
ma'am.
One was 0.01 microfarad.
Yes, so 0.1. Then what is the value of R1 and R2 you have found out?
One was 2.75, another one was 5.5.
Is it correct, Suparna? Is it same with you?
Ma'am, I have calculated, I have, previous class, sir had given C1 value 0.1 microfarad and C2 value 0.1 microfarad. And I had calculated R1 is 2.7 kilo ohm and R2 is 1.83 kilo ohm.
Yes, ma'am, me also.
Yes. So these are my values.
Yes, but Pradeep, how it is different for you?
Ma'am, I can show you my calculation part also.
Yes, no. You just check it whether there will be some difference. They are getting 2.7 and 1.83, and you are getting what is the value? R1 value?
Ma'am, 2.7 and 5.5. Means, ma'am, R1 value is varying.
You got the R2 value 2.7. Your R1 value is 2.7.
No, ma'am, my R2 value is 2.7, but R1 value is 5.5.
No, you have got two different values, no? Because they are getting in R1 2.7 and R2 value is 1.83. Right, Suparna?
Yes, ma'am.
So, everyone is getting the same output, then there will be some
blood. Actually, ma'am, R1 I got 2.7, I told by mistakenly, but R2
okay.
I am getting 5.5.
But try to check it once more, okay? Try to check the calculation once more, but output is there, right? But you can check the value and you can then change the value over here and you can do it, okay?
Sure, ma'am.
No, it's one.
Okay. Ma'am, I'll share, ma'am.
Yes, Tanvi, yes.
I just wrote it now, so my graph is coming like this, ma'am.
How this cannot be like this?
I just...
can you please... enlarge your MATLAB code so that I can go through it.
How to enlarge this, ma'am?
Make it full screen. Just a minute.
Ma'am, you can do that.
Yes. I got it. Okay. What is the G value you have taken? That was given to you.
Yes, ma'am. I calculated through R1 and R2. And C, I have taken.
That is the GCS value. Just a minute. Tanmay, whatever value you have found out, you have taken GCS value as G. That cannot be correct. G value is, that is the transfer function that was given to you. Open the transfer function that was given.
Okay, ma'am. Ma'am, this is for the leak lag compensation, not for the uncompensated one. Just that leak lag compensator, ma'am.
Okay. You have taken only leak lag.
Yes, ma'am.
So, still then your output is not correct somehow. Okay.
Ma'am, this one, the first one is for lead compensator, second is for lag compensator, and the multiplication of them is this one, the red one.
Okay. Then a lead compensator, blue color.
Yes, ma'am. And okay, red one is the lag compensator.
Yes, okay. Okay, then. Let me check and then I'll do.
Blue one is the lead compensator, which I think is
lead compensator. Lead compensator is correct. The blue one is correct.
Yes, ma'am. And the red one is lead lag.
Yes, that is. I'm in doubt. Okay, I'll check and then I'll do. Okay.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay.
Excuse me, ma'am.
Yes, please. Yes, ma'am.
Ma'am, after changing the value, ma'am, I am getting the same output without any difference, and it's coming correct, ma'am. Can I show that?
Please, yes. Please share it. Yeah, correct.
Yes, ma'am. This is correct. Ma'am, actually, I forgot to multiply 10^3. That's why it came wrong.
Okay, no issue on that. Okay, thank you. Tanma?
Yes, ma'am.
Please go through the calculation, please.
Yes,
okay.
Ma'am.
Okay, go through it then. Otherwise, your lead compensation output is coming correct, but lag lead compensation is not coming correct. So, try to go through the calculation. But first you do, you have taken with FM is different value for lag compensation and your IM and FM value is given different for lag and lead compensation. Capacitor is different. So first of all, you have to find out the alpha value from that and beta value from that. After finding alpha and beta value, you have to find out R1 and R2 value. On that only, you can directly in GCS, that is the compensated lag lead network that was given to you. Okay, that equation, you directly put the value on that. What is that equation? Can you please tell me?
Which equation, ma'am?
Lag lead equation. GCS equation. That is alpha into 1 plus T1S into 1 alpha. Plus T2S. Yes, 1 plus T2S whole divided by 1 plus alpha T1S into bracket 1 plus beta T2S. In that equation, you can directly put the value of alpha. You have already found out the value of tau and tau 2 and beta value you have already found out, then you can directly, or instead that alpha value you can directly put R2 by R1 plus R2 and beta is nothing but equal to 1 by alpha. You can find out from that equation also after finding R1 R2. Okay, then you can find out T1 or tau 1 value that is given with the equation, that is given with the formula. Okay, and you can find out the GCS equation that is I told you, then you will get the values. Okay, we try to do that. If any problem, then I will tell you. Okay,
that's okay, what ma'am. I did, ma'am.
But still, then you check it. Okay, once more, you check it. Okay,
yes, ma'am.
Okay. So next, we're going to start the anyone else wants to share the screen? Okay, then we'll start the new experiment, that is experiment number 4, and Sir will explain you all that. Okay, sir.
Hello, madam.
Ha, sir.
Ma'am, madam, mukha kothili. I question that the only result you see on compensating network.
Yes, sir.
Output of compensator, it will be from the bandpass filter and bandpass filter. That I want to
sir, I am unable to understand your question, please. Can you please repeat it, sir?
Actually, what is the response of your compensating network when you are using the lag lead network? Whether the response is a bandpass filter or bandstop filter? I want to see the result. So,
sir,
without using any.
Okay, without using any compensated network.
Without any on compensation network. Only you have designed only alpha only to one part here.
Yes, yes, sir. Yes, sir. I told that to Tanma that he has done the same process because after yes, finding yes, you are giving it the value of 5M and FM. For lag lead compensation, you are given with R1 and C1 value, R2 and C1 and C2 value, and they have already found out alpha and beta from that, and as well as R1 R2. First of all, R1 R2, then alpha beta. Then after finding that, they can directly put the these values in equation. That is GCS equal to alpha into 1 plus tau 1 S whole into 1 plus tau 2 S whole divided by 1 plus alpha tau 1 s into 1 plus beta tau 2 s. After filling all these values in this equation, then only they can go for the output part. They will go for the MATLAB code part. Then only they can get the output. Yes. I have given, sir, the previous question that in the problem statement I have given the phase margin, gain margin, all that I have given steady state value. In that, they have found out few people had gone with that process, and Dharma has gone the process that was explained by you. So I told you all the students to go by both the process, whether you are getting the same output or not. You can check it, because in that case transfer function is given. Here no transfer function is given. Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yes.
My intention was to show me the compensating network and what is its response. It just looks like a bandpass filter or bandstop filter. That I want to say. If it is if it is properly watched whether it is bandpass or bandstop, then any uncompression network, we have to use the compression network, then you get the response. That is the second thing.
Yes.
But first we want to see what is your response for a lag in network, whether it is only watched as a bandpass filter or bandstop filter. That is my aim. So simply R1 R2 C and calculate already the alpha or tau 1 is known, put in the transfer function, find out the Bode response. And bandpass filter. If we find the bandpass filter, then from the bandpass filter, I want to find out what is your FL, that is the lower cutoff frequency, what is the higher cutoff frequency, and then what is your corner frequency. If this is obtained whether it is bandpass or bandstop, then you have to apply to an uncompensating network to get the overall response of the system. But first stage, you have to implement design and implementation of any lag lead network. So that only you have to see what is its response. All you understand?
Yes.
All you understand or not? Hello? So
yes,
I
sir.
Think that so my thing is that I want to without taking on then we have to implement the second test by using the outcome field.
Sir, your voice is breaking, sir.
Hello. Hello.
Your voice is breaking, sir.
Hello. Now it is audible?
Yes, sir. Yes,
yeah.
Sir, yes.
So first you design and implement a compensating network, that is a lag net compensating network depending upon the problem statement. And after that you use a compensating network with uncompensated and check both the responses of which is better. So initially you have to design a lag net compensating network, and we have to check whether the response really behaves as like a just like a bandpass filter or bandstop filter, and from that we have to find out the FL, that is the lower cutoff frequency, what is that, higher cutoff frequency, and the frequency, and we have to corner frequency. That thing we have to find out, and what is the bandwidth. So every parameter you can find out from that compensating network. After that, you have to use that compensating network in your own compensating network and check with the response of the system, whether it is improved or not. So that's my point. Okay, only 2 to 3 lines. So if you have 9, no you can show me the result, then better, otherwise you will go to the next. So this is my point.
Okay, sir. Sir, we'll tell them they will do at the last half an hour. We'll start the new experiment today itself, or we'll go for the first half an hour. They'll do the MATLAB and then.
Actually, today your all you have the knowledge about the PID controller.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. They have already studied in process control.
Process control.
Yes, sir.
No need to explain here.
Sir, we have just learned about, like, we just touched the derivative controller, but not PID one, sir.
Till now, you have not gone through the PID controller,
Kanman? No, sir. Sir taught us proportional, then integral, then derivative. He was explaining in the mist. He hadn't completed derivative, and PID he hasn't touched, ma'am.
Okay.
So already you know your proportional controller, you know the derivative controller, you know the integral controller, but what is the overall PID controller you don't know, I think.
Yes, sir.
No, sir. So
this is the most important thing. If initially this is the PID controller is the most important. So you know the what is a controller, that things you already know. Basically, any industry, if you go, there are the controller used, and that can be a proportional controller, then can be integral controller, then a derivative controller. And some cases, by addition of the proportional with integral, that can be generated a proportional integral. By combining the proportional with the derivative, that will be proportional derivative. And some cases, proportional with integral with the derivative controller. So the thing is that in proportional control, what is the condition? Proportional condition
will increase, the amount of control action will also increase.
Yeah. So here basically the output of the comparator. So you know the block diagram, I think. So in that case, your reference, already you know. So in proportional, what happened? The output of the controller. So that is proportional to the error signal. So which is the basically that is the input to the controller. So that is a proportional controller system. So the output to the controller output is basically the actuating signal. So that is a function of error. So that you do that P is equal to Kp into E. Or like actual will I want to discuss. After that then it will be better.
Yes, sir. Can I share the PID controller block diagram?
Yes.
So that, I'm sharing the PID controller block diagram so that you can explain them. Just a minute, sir. Is it visible to everyone?
Yes, ma'am.
Sir, I'm directly going to the PID controller. This one, sir.
Okay.
Ma'am, can you explain a little about derivative control also, since sir hadn't finished that, ma'am?
Sir, derivative control. Yes, ma'am.
Okay. So, derivative controller.
Yes, sir. They want to.
Yes, sir. So actually what happens, in the proportional controller, basically the output of the controller, that is the actuating signal, that is proportional to the error. So error is the difference between the reference signal and the feedback signal.
Yes.
So, but in the integral, the actuating signal is basically proportional to integral or integration of the error signal. So that is the input to this controller. But in derivative controller, to basically the actuating signal, and that is the output of the controller, is proportional to the derivative or differentiation of the error signal. So error signal is the difference between the reference signal and the output signal. So if you see here, so yes, RS stands for the reference signal, that is the error. and so KD is the basically the proportional with the derivative proportional constant, derivative gain constant or rate constant, and then it is out physics depend to the so in this case, so basically what happened? It is basically in the derivative controller.
Sir, can I go to the sir, should I go to the derivation part?
Okay. So if you see here, it produces the controller output or the actuating signal that produces an output, which is the derivative of the error signal. So if you see ut, ut is the in the time domain, ut is proportional to d by dt of et, et is the error signal. So since we have to take a proportional constant, that is our kd, that is ut is equal to kd is some constant into kd into d by dt of ut. So by taking the Laplace transform on the both sides, so US is equal to KD, Laplace of derivative will be LCS. So because we are taking the initial conditions are zero, so US is equal to KD, S into ES. So US divided by ES. So that is the output of the controller, that is the, and that is the input. That is the error signal in the Laplace domain. So that will be KDS, KD to S. So this KD is otherwise known as a derivative gain constant, or that is known as the rate constant. So if you see, so this is also the output of the controller action, output of the controller, or this is the input to the controller, so that will be gain, and that gain will be the output divided by input, and that's the KDS.
Sir, your voice is breaking.
Hello?
Yes, sir.
Hello?
Now it is audible? Yes, sir.
Divided by ES. So that is the output of the controller divided by the error signal upper domain, that will be gives the transfer function of the controller. Because the input is the error signal and the output is the basically the that is your actuating signal, that is in the US, and ES is the error signal, that's the input to the controller. So that will be gain, that is output by input. So that will be gain into KD into S. Madam, next. Hello.
Yes, sir.
Next.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Next, go to the PID controller.
So what the advantages in derivative controller? So basically,
yes.
The thing is that limitation of derivative control is that it doesn't respond to sudden error. If there is a some error, will be generated by taking the derivative of a constant. What happened? What is the derivative of constant? Hello? What is the
zero.
So if there is a constant field of error, so by taking the controller output, that will give a zero output. So in that case, it does not respond to a sudden error. So derivative controller, so that is the limitation of the derivative control. But in some cases, like suppose we are given a constant, instead of that, we given a AT, that is a ramp signal, where A is a constant in the time domain. So in that case, here it gives a derivative of some AT. So I can say so basically, your P is proportional to d by dt, or p is equal to kp into kd into d by dt. So that seems already you know. So where kd is the derivative gain constant and rate constant. So your output is your ps, you can make it in a bar. So PS is equal to KD into S into ES. So,
sir, are you presenting your screen?
Okay.
Sir, should I stop sharing the screen so that you can present?
Okay. Madam, because I'm explaining, then we'll go directly to PID.
Okay, sir, I'll stop sharing.
How?
Yes, is my screen visible to everyone?
No, madam, my screen is visible.
Yes, sir.
PEG proportional d by dt, or we are taking that or PEG equal to KD into d by dt. So it is your KD is the derivative gain constant, or that is your rate constant. And then we are taking the Laplace. So PS is equal to KD into SES. So PS divided by, that is the proportional PS divided by ES. So that will be KD into S. Okay. So this is the gain, or that is the your the transfer function, that is the PS by ES. But now we will take the different cases. So first you take a step type. Suppose ET is a step type, that is a constant. Suppose ET is equal to A. So that is a step type, a constant value, step type error. So in that case, what is the proportional? So P is equal to, that is your KD, to derivative of constant, that will be zero. Derivative of some constant. So error signal is your step signal, and so it will be zero. But that means, if we have a step signal, so controller output, that is in the form of error, some constant value, the controller output will be zero. So that means it does not respond to a sudden error. So in that case, there is a problem. So that is the limitation. That means it does not respond to sudden errors. Suppose we are using a RAM type. Second case. Suppose second RAM type ET. So that is equal to AT. A into T. So AT means it is a linearly rising with a slope of AT. Y is equal to MX. So it is T. And the slope is A. It is slope LA. So it is AT. So it is an error signal. So ET is equal to AT. So it is a ramp having value slope is A, ET is 1, then it is only T. So that is unit ramp. But in this case, amplitude is slope is A is given. So ET is equal to AT. So in that case, what is the P? So P is equal to KD D by DT of AT. So what is that result? So KD, so that will be, what is that derivative? A into KD. So the proportional, that means in this case, controller responds suddenly. Because a amplitude of a pipe is given, so it will be increased by a factor of KD. So if initial case it is only pipe, now by using the step signal, RAM signal with a slope of 5, then it will be increases. So increases means, so that means controller responds suddenly for a RAM type error. So in that case, so what happens? At whenever at any T is equal to T1, when the RAM type error is just applied, the derivative controller responds when the error is zero. So that means it sends a control signal in anticipation of error. So it is called the anticipatory controller mode. No. Derivative controller basically does not eliminate the steady state error properly, but it improves the transient state characteristics of the system. So in derivative controller responds basically 90 degree phase error by considering a sine signal. Your sign signal number? Caller? Hello?
Yes, sir.
So yes, the sir. Thing is that when the RAM type of error is just applied, what have you gotten? You have gotten the response, your controller responds quickly. So that means whenever you are applying the step signal, the error, it will be gives zero. proportional that is your controller output is zero, but when your RAP is applied, it is response your quickly. So that means it sends a control signal in anticipation of error. So it is called a anticipatory controller also mode. So derivative control mode is otherwise known as anticipatory control mode. Because in save signal directly, only we are getting zero, but whenever we apply the RAMP type of signal, we are getting that it is respond quickly. So there is an anticipation of error. So it is also called anticipatory controller mode. So but so this anticipation nature that measures result in a instability. But the thing is that derivative controller improves the transient, but that it does not eliminate the steady state error properly, because we are taking a constant error value, so derivative will be zero. So it does not eliminate the steady state error, but it improves the transient state characteristics of the system. Now we have to consider another case where the ET is equal to a sine omega t. So it is a sine signal, sinusoidal signal, where a is the amplitude, omega is the angular frequency, t is the time. Then the proportional will be your kd into derivative of a sine omega t. So n sine omega t. So by taking the derivative, what happens? So it will be kd into a. So derivative will be like that, omega into cos omega t. So it is what? Kd a omega. So cos omega t becomes sine 90 degree plus omega t plus 90. So 90 means it is 5/2. Yes. Omega t plus 5/2. So that means derivative control responds. So there is a lead. Lead by 90 degree in phase. So response is faster. Thank you. Suppose you have started your error signal a sine omega t, but the controller output will be a 90 degree phase lead with the error signal. So that means it will be faster. So because there is a 90 degree phase shift, so the response is faster in your derivative controller. Bujhela, all of you understand? All of you understand?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay. So it is fast thing that it only improve the transient state. Transient means it improves the speed of the response of the system, and so the response in the derivative control is faster. What are the disadvantages? The disadvantage that it does not eliminate the steady state error, because by considering the step type error, we get the derivative constant that will be zero. So, but if you are using the RAMP type error, by taking the derivative, we get that it responds quickly. So, that is another thing where derivative control is known as the anticipatory control. Because it removes the instability. So it is sometimes it may result in instability due to this case. So it sends a control signal in anticipation of the error. So it is an anticipated control. Okay. So already you know, so in integral, the action is just opposite. So in your derivative control, what you obtain, there is a 90 degree phase shift in the phase lead, because omega t plus 5/2, so it is a faster. Similarly, in integral, what happens? Integral, 90 degree phase
lag.
So already you know, I think.
Lag.
Lag, yes, sir,
lag compensation.
So suppose E is equal to A sine omega t. So in by taking the integral controller, so here P is equal to your KI, so KI, integration of A sin omega t. So that will be minus 1 by A is a constant. So A divided by omega KI by omega, that is what it is. Sin omega T or cos omega T. But sin derivative is minus cos.
Minus cos.
So minus cos omega t.
Yes,
sir. Oh, okay. So next it will be minus.
Sir, you have already given the minus symbol, so no need to give extra minus.
So minus j a divided by omega. So that is the cos omega t. You can write time omega t minus pi by 2. So there is a phase shift of 90 degree, but it's a lag network due to the minus sign. So integral control response lags by 90 degree. So the response is slower. Understand or not? Also yes. Understand not? Okay. So, but what happens? It improves the steady state error, because whenever we are giving any constant step time signal due to the integration, it is. Suppose we are taking next case. Suppose we are taking et is equal to a. Suppose a constant when that is a step type error, having amplitude a. Then what is p? P is equal to ai integration of a dt. So a dt will be ki into a into t. So if you see, so it will give a constant proportional action that will improve. And it will respond faster. So first step input. So it will eliminate the AAS. So it will improve your steady state error. Because the error A will let be A is a constant value, that is the error. The form of error is a constant value. And by taking the integral, AI with the integral constant, it will increase linearly. So if we can increase linearly, it will increase the response. And we can improve the steady state error. But the response is slower. So that means, so limitation of the controller is that it is slower. And so due to slower, the rate of change of control output is basically there is an oscillation present. So already you know in a proportional controller, so on-off control is otherwise known as proportional control, and it react to a sudden change in the instantly, but error you cannot remove completely in your proportional. So proportional integral derivative, all of you know? Any doubt? Hello?
No, sir.
Okay, now we will go for the proportional integral and derivative. So in that case, hello, madam. Hello.
Yes, sir.
Share on the screen, yeah.
Okay, sir. Is it visible to everyone?
Yes, sir.
Is it visible? Okay, sir.
Yes, ma'am.
So I'm directly going to be PID control.
So best. So now integral, what is the integral?
Integral, do you know or will explain it once more?
All of you know the integral and proportional.
Yes, yes. Yes, sir. They know it, so directly go to the PID.
So in PID controller, we have to use the combination of proportional, integral with a derivative. So if you see this diagram, it is given. The RS is the reference signal, that is in S domain. It is a summing amplifier or error comparator like, or error detector. That output is the plus line, that is a negative feedback. So output is ES, and it is given in the form of a PID controller. So where for proportional only KP. So it is inside bracket, it is given little 1 plus 1 by ti. Ti is the integral time constant. So Kp by ti, that is your ki. And Kp into Td, that is your Kd. So that is Kp, you get taken common outside. So 1 plus 1 by ti is plus Tds. So that is the output of the controller. And that is the output of the US. And it is given to a system. Or a plant, I don't transfer for 2 years. And the output is just this, a couple of. So by taking this, you can write get P.
Sir, should I go to the derivation part?
Yes, sir. So the overall transfer function I will determine. Edi kon kori bo? Okay. So now you need to PID control. Output is a combination of your proportional integral and derivative. So if you see here, UP is proportional to your output UP is proportional to your ET plus integration of ET plus derivative of ET. This is the error signal. That is ET. That is the output of the comparator error detector. And by considering the all the proportional constants, like proportional UP, you can write the sum of the multiplication of the constants with your error signal. So UP you can write KP into ET plus KI integration of ET plus KD d by dt of ET. Now we're taking the Laplace transform on the both sides. So US is equal to KP ES plus KI by S ES, because we're taking the Laplace of the integration ES by S. Then KDS into ES. Next. What are you talking about?
Yes, sir.
So by taking ES into this side to numerator side, the transfer function might be the controller output divided by controller input. So controller output, so that is the transfer function, now becomes the ratio of the controller output, the instrument to the ES. So KP plus AI by S plus KDI. So by taking the KP as a common outside, so KP is going outside, so 1 plus AI by KP plus KD by KP. So you can write EIE, that is the integral time constant. So integral time constant is equal to KP by AI. So you can write 1 by STI. EIE is the integral time constant. Similarly, what is KD? So KD is equal to KD divided by KP. So you can write also KP whole into 1 plus 1 by TIS plus TDS. So that is the transfer function. All of you understand? Any doubt regarding this derivation? Regarding this derivation, any doubt? Hello?
Any doubt? Can you please respond?
Sir, last step to take a point after KP common
and then TI in the second. Because KP is taking common. So, whenever taking the KP common in second term, so divide by KP. So, because it will be after cancellation, only will be.
Yes, sir.
Similarly, in the third term, you can take KP as a common. So, it is KD divided by KP. So,
means you are multiplying and dividing both the terms.
It seems KP is taking common.
Means you are multiplying, yes sir. You are dividing it by KP also as well as.
So here in the second term, 1 by TI, you can take it as TI. TI is equal to KP by KI. In the way, it is a denominator. KP, TI is a denominator. So it is 0, TI. TI is equal to KP by KI. So now what is KD? KD is equal to KD divided by KP. So the final expression will be KP whole into 1 plus 1 by TIS plus TDS. And TI is the integral time constant, but TD is the differential or derivative time constant. Integral time constant and it's a derivative time constant. So this TI also you can now it is a Richter controller, that is you. You know that is the remember integral controller is known as a Richter controller, a derivative controller is known as anticipatory controller. So that is a rate mode, it is in a reset mode. So that will be the gives the overall transfer function. And the thing is that it is represented in the form of 50, but the above transfer function is represented in the form of your Fp, Kt, Ki. But this is only represented in the form of Fp, which is interior time constant and derivative time constant. Okay, next madam.
Sir, now this is all
type of controllers, then I will go for the PID controller using Zeigler Nichols method. Should I share that, sir?
Yes, sir. Okay, sir.
So, what are the observations you are obtaining using PID controller? What are the advantages? So, basically, it improves both the transient response as well as your steady state response. Because we are using the integral, so integral basically improves your integral basically improves particular.
So, is my screen visible to everyone?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, yes, okay. Okay, till this, sir has already explained to you all to this. Okay. So, next we'll go for the Zeigler Nichols method. Sir, can you hear me?
Yes, 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 madam, here, but I lost my network connection due to
power failure. Sir, you have already explained you have already explained up to this much. So, I will directly go to the Zeigler Nichols method, sir. This is only the derivation part that you have explained. Yes, sir, I am directly going to the Zeigler Nichols method, sir. Yes. Yes, sir. Two methods, first and second method. Sir, so many images are coming from your background. Sir, can you hear me?
Hello?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir, there is noise from your background, sir. Should I share my screen?
Hello, it is audible? Hello.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Yes, sir.
So, this is the block diagram. So, today's experiment is your design of a PID-based flow process controller. Design of a PID-based flow process controller. Write down the name of the experiment. So, what are you obtaining your PID controller? The advantages, since we are using an integral controller with a derivative controller, and the advantage of integral controller is that it improves the steady state error of the system. But whereas the derivative controller improves the transient response of the system. So, by using both the integral and derivative controller, we can improve both the transient as well as studied it as well. So this is the first point. And the second thing is that by using PID controller, you will know that integral controller acts as a lag compensated network. So that means it acts as a low pass filter. And since the derivative controller behaves as just like a high pass filter, so by using the both the PID controller, we can get the response of band pass filter, and that will provide the response both the low pass as well as band pass. So that is the advantages that we can get by using PID as compared to your proportional integral derivative or proportional with integral and proportional to derivative. So basically we are using a PID algorithm. So by using that algorithm, so how it will be helpful in a industry for controlling the different physical controlling the different parameters like flow, pressure, temperature, level. So that we will discuss. So first, all to draw the flow diagram of your flow process. Already you have this diagram. The diagram was you compare.
No, sir.
So this is the you write down the your aim of the experiment. Design of a PID based flow process control. Design of a PID based flow process control. PID based flow process control. Okay. So what is your objective? So objective is first we have to study the different elements involved in the flow process control. So since the block diagram which is presented here consists of different elements, they are arranged in a proper way to get the certain objective, that means to control the flow in any industry. So we have to first know what are the elements involved in that flow process and what are the functions or characteristics. And accordingly, we have to use that flow process controller in an industry. So the thing is that, so we have to first study the characteristic element, and then we have to study the characteristics of the state value with respect to your what you use by using the algorithm, PID algorithm. Because the output of the error detector or comparator is basically the error signal, and how the PID algorithm is helpful for removing that error and give a controlling signal, activity signal that proportional to the, or that is proportional to a integral or the derivative, how will you obtain, and that will be match our set point to our set point or the output response or output to the set point. So that case we have to use. So basically, first objective is we have to study the different elements. Second is we have to study the characteristics of the set value or measured value. Set value or measured value with respect to the number of samples. So we have to take the different output value and then we have to find out its characteristics. So basically flow process. So there are different processes involved in the industry, starting from the pressure, temperature, flow, level. So different processes in the industry takes place. So basically, if you consider the flow process variable is a fast changing. Fast changing means with a very fraction of second, it can the output changes very rapidly. So in that case, we cannot control over it. So the since it is a fast changing process, the flow process variable, so the it will be goes from one steady state to other steady state with a very short time interval. And so within the since it has also very small amplitude with some oscillations, it will also of course. So this is the main thing in flow process. So first thing is that flow process is a fast changing. So fast changing means it will be change its steady state from one point to other with a very short time interval, which is fast thing. So we cannot predict its amplitude, its behavior, or its characteristics. The second thing is that flow oscillation also gives a very small amplitude, which is difficult to measure, then observe, and rectify, and then we have to take the output. So this is the thing. So next, what are the elements involved? So you know, set point is the reference point, that is the input point, that is the set value is provided, and then we have to use PID algorithm. So PID algorithm basically is a program that is written in computer, and we have to. There are different algorithms that is used. That is the Ziegler-Nichols method technique. There is the Nicol, and there is another method also. There are two methods basically we are using. So PID algorithm will be different depending upon the KP, KI, and KD. And we have to choose the particular value of KP, KI, and KD for which it gives a better response. That means it can improve both the transient response as well as it improves the steady state error of the system. So next is the PID algorithm. Basically, the program we have to write in computer. It takes all this input and the process as per the instructions we written, and it provides the output. So next is the DAC. DAC, since the output is basically in the form of the digital, because we have to run this program in a computer, and computer will understand your digital data. So that program is written in the digital form. But to run our industry, we are required as analog, that all these signals or the element that involve that provides the output in the form of the voltage or current, and that should be in the analog form. So there is a requirement of DAC. DAC stands for digital to analog converter, that provides, and that converts the digital data into a corresponding analog form. So it is basically the circuit that converts the digital data into corresponding analogous to analog, analogous to analog format, corresponding analogous analog format, and then it takes to the, that means it takes the input as a binary digit and provides the output in terms of the voltage. In the voltage or current form, you can get the result. So now, since and then the DAC output is given to voltage to current converter, because all these operations are controlled in the terms of current, and so there is a conversion principle from voltage to current, because in the plant or any industry, to see there is a requirement of we have to take the pressure. So there is some pneumatic control valve are used which takes the input in the form pressure, and but there is a conversion from the current to pressure, and a relation is also exists between that. So for that case, since we have already a digital voltage, that is, now we have a voltage in the analog form, we have to require to use some device or circuit that will convert a certain voltage into corresponding current converter. Then there is a I2P converter. So basically, V to I converter is a circuit that is used for converting the voltage. That is, for the range is basically since the digital output, the voltage is the form 0 to 5 volt, or that is a 0 to 12 volt. If we consider the range is 0 to 5, so that the minimum value will be 0 and the maximum value will be 5 volt. And we have to use some convert like V to I that will convert certain range of voltage that is from 0 to 5 to current range is 4 to 20 milliampere. So 0 to 5 voltage is proportional to 4 to 20 milliampere. That means minimum voltage of 0 responds to a 4 milliampere, maximum voltage of 5 volt, that is a response to 20 milliampere. So within the range, we have to convert. So 0 to 5 volt is the signal digital form, signal is converted into corresponding current in the 4 to 20 milliampere. So that is a specified range, is specific. That is the range specified for a current case. And then there is a I2P converter. So that is the current to pressure converter, because any control, since there is a valve, and that will be act as a final control element, and that will you have to operate, we have to apply certain pressure. But the input is current. So there is some requirement of device like a I2P converter that will convert a certain amount of current range to corresponding pressure range. So the current which is 5 to 20 milliampere, we have 4 to 20 milliampere, we have to convert into so basically into PSI, some certain range that will only tell. 3 to 15 PSI. मने रखा. हेलो, इट इज ऑडिबल. हेलो हेलो.
यस सर
इट्स ऑडिबल.
ओके, सो देयर इज अ करंट टू प्रेशर कन्वर्टर मींस अ सर्टेन रेंज ऑफ करंट दैट इज व्हिच इज इन द रेंज ऑफ 420 मिली एंपियर इज रिक्वायर्ड टू कन्वर्ट इनटू सर्टेन प्रेशर टू ऑपरेट योर वाल्व. बिकॉज़ वाल्व इज योर फाइनल कंट्रोल एलिमेंट, टू कंट्रोल इट वी हैव टू अप्लाई द फोर्स इन द फॉर्म ऑफ सम प्रेशर और प्रेशर that will be whether we have to make it on or off. So depending upon the operation of the valve, we require some pressure. So that current we have to require to convert into pressure to operate the final control element, that will be a control valve. And so the current which is range in the range of 4 to 20 milliampere is related to 3 to 15 PSI. पढ़ाई थी क्या process control पढ़ा लेंगे. जानते कि करंट इज इट इज द 420 मिली एंपियर दैट इज द मिनिमम वैल्यू मैक्सिमम वैल्यू दिस टेंड्स टू 3 टू 15 PSI. व्हाट इज द फुल PSI?
व्हाट इज द सर
PSI? PSI
पाउंड्स पर स्क्वायर इंच.
हां वेरी गुड. सो दैट इज इन द जो पाउंड्स पर स्क्वायर इंच दैट इज द FPS बेसिकली द सिस्टम व्हाट इज CGS FPS MKS सिस्टम SI सिस्टम. सो वी आर बेसिकली देयर ब्रिटिश system, they are implemented this system that is the design is accordingly they are converted that 420 milliampere to the foot pound second system that is FPS system that is, and under that is 4 to 20 milliampere current is converted to 3 to 15 PSI. That means 4 milliampere which is the minimum range is corresponds to 3 PSI and the 20 milliampere that is the maximum value of current is related to 15 PSI. So every signal that is a controller output or that it should be in the range of 4 to 20 milliampere, and that will give the corresponding pressure range that is a 3 to 15 PSI. So depending upon that pressure, we have to control our valve, and where the valve will be act as a final control element, and depending upon the pressure, will be converted to some mechanical motion. A mechanical movement. Mechanical movement means we can open or close the valve, and we can stop the operation. And otherwise, we can continue the operation. And depending upon the requirement, we can control the flow with the according our requirement. And such that control valve operation will try to set your process tank. Because suppose there is a pipe and there is a tank, and where the water is already given. And there is a flow coming. So there is a inflow and there is a outflow. So depending upon the difference between inflow and outflow, there is a level of the liquid in the tank will rise or fall. So if the outflow rate is basically higher than the inflow rate, so then the level of the liquid will sort of decreases. And suppose if the outflow rate is very less, inflow rate is higher, then level of the liquid increases. But our aim is now in this case, that means we have to control the flow. So how will we control the flow? By using the control valve. So that control valve we have to use at the output section in the pipe, in the cylinder, water tank. So if you use the control valve and that you have to stop it by using some pressure and the flow rate we have to control, then the control valve will be slightly opening or slightly closing or accordingly. The flow rate we can maintain, and so that control valve will seems to be connected to a process tank where the all the processes in an industry will be takes place, and that will be tries to set our point to set our control output signal to our set point, so that will minimize our error signal, because the error signal is the difference between the reference point signal and controller the output signal. So the depending upon the control valve sizing or depending upon the control valve flow rate, we can manually control over the flow rate, and that is given into the process tank. The process tank where there is a flow in, you can see the diagram, and there are two arrow marks given. In the one is given the vertical downward motion, that is the flow in. One is going in the horizontal direction, that is the flow out. So if by using the control bar, we can control the flow in or flow out. So manually set with our fully open or fully closed, or that is manual. According to our requirement, we have to control this valve. And then that output, that is the flow, so that is in the form of the meter cube per second, that is the volume flow rate of the water or anything, that is the material. And since that is the, again, that is the, in the form of the physical variable, but for transmission purpose and for measurement purpose, first we measure, then we transmit, and then we have to control it. We have to convert that the output of the flow rate into a corresponding signal form. And there is a flow transmitter that consists of the, that will sense the flow, and then we measure the flow, and then we try, then convert that output into suitable form for further processing. Because whenever we measure the flow by using different sensing devices or detecting devices like venturimeter or piezometer, or you know that in IDS, I think that all the sensors or devices, instruments that is used for detecting the flow are the flowmeter, venturi flowmeter, Peter tube. So there are three different types of the flow sensing instruments. But that sensing instrument gives the output that is not suitable for further processing. So what have to, we have to detect that flow by using that sensor, but that that is the but our aim is to convert in a suitable form for further processing. We have to use some transmitter that will convert that corresponding flow signal into corresponding signal for that signal may be in the not suitable with very low amplitude. Then we can also use some amplifying device that will convert into a suitable form. So the output of the flow transmitter now gives a current signal in the range of 4 to 20 milliampere. But again, this is a current signal, but our requirement again is a voltage. So we have to use current to voltage. So 4 to 20 milliampere, which corresponds to voltage 0 to 5 volt. So 5 milliampere, that is the relate to 0 volt, 20 milliampere relate to 5 volt. So this is the minimum to maximum value, that is the range specified for current, that is equivalent to 0 to 5 volt, because that to represent the low signal or high signal, to we are using current to voltage converter. That 4 to 20 milliampere current is changed to 0 to 5 volt. Then, so that is ADC. So then we have to use analog to digital converter. Analog to digital converter, then it is given to output. Then that will give the detect, because the PID algorithm basically operates on a computer. Our requirement is, in the ETG, we are obtaining the voltage, and that is 0 to 5 volt. Every low signal is dependent with, corresponding to 0 voltage, that is the low voltage. Every high signal is corresponding to a 5 voltage. So to represent all the signals involved and to write the algorithm, and that should be run in a computer, we require a algorithm, and that algorithm is, should be contain some signal. To represent that signal, we have to represent some voltage. So any low level signal is represent to 0 volt, and every high is 5 volt. So all the signals we have to convert into the corresponding digital form. So analog to digital, so there is a requirement of analog to digital ADC. So now the output is in digital form. Then the PID algorithm, again we will compare the set point or with the output of the ADC. Then we will get the error. That error again we have to implement some algorithm we have to implement. So that will give the output. Similarly, this process will continue unless and until the error detector output or comparator output must be zero. So we have to do this. So this process basically the process block diagram that is used for controlling the flow as a process variable in any industry. So all of you understand, or any doubt regarding this element, what are that involved in a flow process control, you can ask and I will explain it. Hello, all of you understand?
Sir, so flow in should be connected to the control valve, na?
Yeah. Flow transmitter, output of this
in that the flow in is connected to process tank. I'm telling that the flow in should be connected to control valve, then the process tank.
No. Actually, the thing is, the process tank where all the processes take place in industry, that is connected. Suppose we are a tank. Here, that tank will act as a process. As because there is some water is inside it, water is going outside it. There all these elements inside that is the total is taken as a process. So flow is coming here. But depending upon the difference between the flow in and flow out, so there may be some error will be generated. So we have to connect the flow in, that is the process tank, to a pipe. So due to the difference between flow in and flow out, the level of the liquid inside the tank will rise or fall. That we have to decide. If the flow out is more than the flow in, then level of the liquid will increase. If the flow out is less than the flow in, the level of the liquid will decrease. So in an industry, so then the process tank, that one means a simple tank. So where all these systems or the elements that is involved in the plant, but all other things were there connected. So control, your controller is the that will be your PID algorithm that will run in a computer. So that will be the controller. So depending here, we have to change or various the different constants like proportional constant or integral time constant or derivative constant, or you can use the time TI, integral time constant, or your derivative time constant KP. So we have to choose a particular value of KP, KI and KD, or KP, TI and TD, or which gives a most that will improve both the transient response as well as the steady state response, and will give the better response as compared to your any proportional, integral or derivative. So one thing you remember, that there is a current to pressure. Current is 4 to 20 milliampere, is equivalent to 3 to 15 psi. And that is your, that means 4 milliampere is very small value, that is related to 3 psi to psi for the pressure, and 20 milliampere is correspond to 15 psi, the pounds per square. So depending upon the pressure, we have to control our final control element, that we are using. That final control element is a control valve. So that valve will, there are different types of valve, control valve, opening, closing valve, sort manual opening, or automatic, or we have to, so different valves will be discussed when we go to the industrial control or process control. There is a short opening valve, equal percentage valve, linear valve. So there are different type of valves. So depending upon the requirement, that valve we have to use for controlling that pressure. So you can use the valve. That valve will give the signal. So process tank will be, that is applied to process. Any doubt, or we can come to the direct point. So what we have to take, so there is a differential pressure. So this is the front panel diagram of a process control trainer that is used in your lab, but due to this COVID-19 situation, you are not come. So it is not possible to take all the readings and explain everything. So you can take, and this trainer kit is basically consist of a, you can see your red, that is your control valve. So the image, sir?
Yes,
hello.
Sir. You
have got a manual DIC, a trainer manual got a DIC. So the image, sir? So you can see the panel, So if you see in the left side, the process control trainer kit, and that trainer kit basically used for controlling the flow, controlling the level. So this kit, and if you see in the left side, that is a that is a power supply kit, and to connect all the devices to it and to supply the power to operate all the devices or instruments that are used in this diagram. In this case, we have to use the power supply. And the thing is that there are, you can see, there is a DC power supply you can connect by push button, you can use. So directly power is given in this case, and it will be, that is, there are sensor selection. So there are, since we are using the different process, different the physical parameters or physical quantity, we are interested. So we can control the pressure, we can control the level. So this is the case. But to sense it and to get that result, there is a panel given, multi-channel DPM. DPM stands for differential pressure meter. So that will give. Then there is a signal conditioning. Actually, the thing is that after the sensing element, the output is not in suitable form, that is in certain low voltage or low current, so which is not able to process further. So there is requirement of signal conditioning that will convert the output of the sensing element to a suitable form. That you know in IDS, in a measurement system, any sensing element, sensing signal conditioning element, signal processing element, data penetration element, and that signal conditioning element will be converted in suitable form. There are the different things that we have to maintain carefully before using that equipment. That has been written. It is. So then there, because there is a computer is provided where we have to run our PID algorithm. So how will you interface is, the CAD is given, it is connected to computer interface panel. So there are the, depending upon the process variables, which channel we have to select. So channel 0, channel 1, channel 2, channel 3, all are provided. And you can see there is the DAC, digital to analog converter. There is a connection is already provided. There corresponding certain voltage of digital to digital voltage is 0 to 5 volt is corresponding to analog voltage that is in the form G. And suppose there is also that voltage to current converter, and similarly from current to pressure converter, that is 420 milliampere that is connected to a it is. So that 4 to 20 milliampere now to 3 to 15 psi. So that is a kg per centimeter square is given. So that will be as a current to pressure converter, I2P converter, you can see. So basically these two things are given in the air filter regulator, because when the, there is a flow is coming, some air is coming into, if there is a, then the bubble may be come and may, so that may be disturbance will be happen. So there are two air filter regulator are used to control the uniform flow, and the streamlined flow should be maintained throughout the system. And if there is turbidity or there is a turbulence, that we can remove. And if there is air in the mixture, then we can remove it. So it can be open, closed, the arrow mark is given. Now how will you remove open and we close? So that is a pump in that water, what is coming from the tank, process tank, that is given by using that knob or by open or closing, the water is flowing inside it. So when the water is flowing inside it, so this is the first thing, bypass system. You can see in the below, there is a container. That container contains water, and water is coming by using compressor. So that compressor will give the pressure, to water will go through this pipe, the bypass system. Water is coming into the one is the pump in, and then it will pass. So one LPH, one is LPH water. So there are two rotameters for measurement of that. What is the use of rotameter?
For measurement.
अरे तुम ऐसे रोटामीटर का यूज़ कराइए
फ्लो मेजरमेंट
फ्लो प्रेजरमेंटर सो वी कैन सो द वी कैन टेक इट फॉर वन इज़ सेट पॉइंट अनदर इज़ मेजरमेंट पॉइंट So find out the difference between them. We have initially one is the set point, another is the measurement point. So LPH water, that is the, have taken the two things then. So then that will be given to this. So it will be air also inside it, and then here we have to take the difference between them with the pipe ratio. So depending upon the Kp, Ki and Kd value, we can use here to control the valve. So that control valve, if you see, there is an opening, and that opening is in the top, will be automatically pump down, and that will stop the flow of water inside that pipe. Then if we remove it, then automatically it will move and water is going through this. Understand? It is actually connection AG already. So there is an instrumentational amplifier for signal conditioning element that will convert the sensing output element to a suitable for further processing, because our digital, that we require some analog signal to digital, and for the PID algorithm to implement in a computer. So that instrument now can convert the millivolt or milliampere range to some current volt range, and that voltage is converted into some digital analog form to digital form, then it is given to a computer. So there is a thing, if you can see here, there is a level or pressure, that is sensor that directly it detects that thing. And for here, that is a level tank. A level tank you can use for the measurement of a level. When we study the controlling parameter as a level process control, then we have to use it. But for flow cases, so both the rotameter, one is inflow one set point value, another is output set point value, another is measured value. We have to find the, take the difference between them. ये जो height हुआ था जाइए सेटा तुम्हारे computer पे लगी थी वो, है ना? इधर कोड लगी देख लो मैडम उसपे, ऊपर में। हाँ, you can see, so that is given to your CPU directly connected back, and there is a software already implemented that we have to run process control software. If in the lab actually if present, then you can better understand. But from this case, we have just describing our front panel diagram. It is compressor attack, जो तुम्हारा एक रेड एक ब्लू कलर मैंने तो फिर सोल्ड आउट पाइंट पर तो मैं इनिशियली वो आपको वाटर मिल गया बुझिए ला सो इट दिया रेगुलेटर अच्छी मैंने यार उसका रेगुलेटर वन एम टू उसका लो तुम्हारा आई टू पी कॉन्वर्टर रहा जेट इज प्रेशर दैट विल डिटेक्ट कितना प्रेशर कॉरेस्पोंडिंग व्हाट करंट व्हाट द कॉरेस्पोंडिंग प्रेशर दैट वी कैन आल्सो डिटेक्ट ऑल इफ यू अंडरस्टैंड No. So we can control the level of the liquid here by using this three things. One is B7, B8 valve, B7, B8 by opening or closing. We can control the level of the liquid. So we can control the flow. We can also control the level. If you see, so a signal conditioning circuit for flow. So initially we have to measure the flow sensor. You see, it is mentioned is a flow sensor, and the output is in the form of pulses, and that flow sensor will be convert our requirement to convert the voltage for further processing. We have to use that is your flow to voltage, or flow means in the form of a force. Basically, flow is in the form of a force, and since our requirement is to operate in the electrical domain. Since some pneumatic signal, electrical pneumatic, the voltage or current requirement, so we have to convert the corresponding force to voltage converter. And there is a device already connected, and then for span and zero amplifier. Jani to span zero? What is span? What is span? What is the static characteristics of the instrument system, measurement system? Span. Hello. Double EM ra padithibo, electric or electronic measurement span. Okay, so span is actually maximum variation in the input or output. We have to, if there is a, before taking the reading, it is some gives value, that means we have to nullify and that will adjust. And because it will stand from the minimum to maximum value, if there is other some value, we have to nullify and we have to make it at the minimum value, then we have to start. And some amplifier, zero amplifier, and then if initially the gain is increased. So every time the response output also is amplified output. So before that we have to make it to zero. So span zero amplifier. So it will start from this point. And that output is now in the voltage, so that is the sensor output. And then signal it is converted. So similarly for pressure sensor assembly, there is the instrumentation amplifier and gain block also given for taking that reading, and it will be amplified. And also we can use the level DPT flow output. Level is the for liquid level measurement, DPT differential pressure, and flow output, that is out. So that is in the range of 0 to 2.5 volts. So different blocks, because they are given the panel for understanding purpose. So if you see, this is a computer interface panel, you can see briefly. So there are different set below. So we have to connect the different points. So this is the external, we have to connect the channel 0, channel 1, channel 2, channel 3. So from the computer, we have to interface it. So channel 1, we are using for controlling, or you can use channel, because there are multiple options given. If some cases channel 1 is not operating, then we can use for channel 2 for detecting or sensing that measure value, and we can process it accordingly. So there are the connectors, because you have to use some connector that you know. So 25 PIN, that is connector is used, 25 PIN. And that is then there is digital to analog convert, that means you will convert the corresponding digital data to corresponding analog form. Then we have to convert the voltage to current converter. So depending upon our requirement, there are different panel is provided for conversion, and we have to interface our connector to get our certain objective according to our block diagram. All understand? Hello. So this is, you can see, so this is the diagram which shows the multi-channel DPM, that is your, because this, depending upon the sensor selection, we can measure, we can control this parameter, like the physical variable in an industry. Like suppose you have to control the flow, you have to move the knob and keep it in the flow direction. Suppose you have to maintain the level, we have to keep the knob and the level position. NC is not connected. Suppose we have to use for any other measurement like pH, viscosity or any turbidity, you can connect for measuring this. NC, that process, that condition is given for connection. NC is not connected. That means this panel is only used for the measurement of flow and level. And then there are two signal conditioning element output is connected to this. So there are two options is given. Either you connect to 6-7 or you can connect to other 2 points. So 1, 2, 3, 4 is given for number to for connection purpose. So either you can give the DC power supply. And some cases there is a requirement of SCR. SCR is stand for silicon controlled rectifier, that is a thyristor for controlling the different operations in an industry. Now the power electronic devices like thyristors are can be used, because it is some cases it is operated in very high voltage. So in that case we can use it for DC power supply. And there are the different ranges we can press on off switch, power on off, and the voltage is basically varied from 220 to 40 volt. And there are different fuses connected, fuse 1, 2, depending on that is the constructional point of view, they are connected different points, different parts. So, okay, madam, back to. So if you see here, south is through diagram. Okay. So actually this is the wiring connection. Actually if you use that the panel for measurement of flow and for controlling the flow, and then this is the wiring connection. You have to give a password, you have just connect. One that is the point number the pump L, L14 to then EMT8, therefore then pump N15 to EMT8. So this is the connection of the port for connection by using the different connector, and with the DPM reading will not match the power experiment with the rotameter reading as output the square root of the expected. So if you see here channel zero, that is the panel is given in the channel zero, channel one, channel two. That is the output is detected, and the digital PID controller. So they will listen and detect, and it implement that algorithm, PID algorithm, and we have to choose the particular value of KPTI, KD or KPTI and KPD, and that will give the output. That is the output in the form of U, output digital PID controller output U, and that signal in the form of the digital, then we have convert the digital to current. And again, there is the current to pressure, because the to operate that control valve, we require pressure signal. And so 4 to 20 milliampere current will be corresponding to 3 to 15 PSI, and then it is given to a control valve. So control valve, depending on the size or depending upon the types, the valve will operate, and that will modify the flow inflow to the process, and depending upon that, the flow process gives the output, and which again detected by the flow transmitter, and will give the signal. That signal becomes suitable for by using the flow transmitter. Then that flow transmitter output will be given to the sensor signal conditioning like instrumentation amplifier, amplifier like that, and then that output again given to the channel for detecting, for comparing the error, for getting the error, the difference, and get the output. So here we have to use the two type of sensor. One is a turbine flow sensor for flow sensor, orifice flow sensor, and where PB stands for proportional band. So proportional band is equal to 1/kp. You know that is your proportional band is equal to 1/kp. So proportional band allows 60, integral time constant allows 1, TD allows differential. Derivative time constant PD, that is 0.125. For orifice flow sensor, we have to consider the proportional band 140. So KP is equal to 1/PB. So you can determine that. And TI is equal to set 1, and TD you have set 0.08. That will give a better performance, or efficiency will be more. And by setting that, we can control our flow. And that is according to Ziegler-Nicholas. And we will take one class when we discuss the Ziegler-Nicholas. And so PB is 60%, TI is 1 second, ED is 0.125. So this is the set point, this is the algorithm that we are implemented. By setting this parameter value, we can improve the both the system performance, and we can get the error will be less, and it will also improve the transient response or speed response of the system. Also, so this is the diagram. If you see, that is the
sir, orifice by sir, PB ta basic hai achi sir, why PB is more sir?
Because that is depending upon the constant, because the orifice flow meter is operating in different principle, and turbine flow sensor is operating in different principle. The equation, if you see the Q flow rate, that depends upon the your diameter, that is depends upon the area, cross sectional area, that depends upon the constructional point of view. So accordingly, the proportional band we have to set.
Sir, but सर गोटे सर मुझे सर प्रोपोर्शनल बैंड इज द रेंज ऑफ एरर फॉर फॉर व्हिच द कंट्रोलर विल गिव 0 टू 100% आउटपुट सो द एरर सो द एनी सेंसर सर एनी सेंसर दैट वी यूज विल गिव अस सम द विल गिव अस द एक्चुअल फ्लो ऑफ द वाटर और एनीथिंग सो द वैल्यू वोंट चेंज इवन इफ आई यूज अ ऑरिफिस फ्लो सेंसर और अ टर्बाइन फ्लो सेंसर सपोज माय फ्लो रेट इज like 5 meter cube per second. So that won't change. So how is PP changing, sir?
Actually, the thing is that PP depends upon KP. KP is a proportional gain constant. It is not written in the form of KP. It is written in the form of a PP. But how will you know that proportional band? Proportional band is 1 by KP. So that value will be decreased. Because it is 140, so 1 by 140. So then it value will be decreased. Actually, the thing is that whenever we are set this KP, KI, TD, they are changing this parameter value. If we take 139, it also operates. But in that, they are, in the constructional point of view, they are taken this value as the for giving the optimum response. But if we slightly deviate, there will be no change. But ultimately, our aim is to reduce the steady state error and improve the speed of the response. For that case, every time you change KP, TI, TD by very small value, we can increase or decrease. And we have to set the value for which it will give a better response. So that is given 140. And so for it is shown that they are setting and they get that the origin flow sensor where the KP is 1 by 40. So that will be gives a better response. For a turbine flow sensor, they are changing the KP, TI, TD and they get that. Because both of them, you can see, TI both are same, but TD also different. But PB, you don't think that PB is equal to 1 by KP. So because KP value is not given. So KP, we have to obtain from PB value. Okay. So we have to vary the KP, TI, TD for a particular full sensor that will detect. Understand not? So PP means rather than the range of the values you have taken. Here the KP is given in the terms of PB. Hello. So basically addition B will minimize your oscillation overshoot and the process will settle with a small overshoot without error. Overshoot right, you can see the final measurement. So if you see here, there is a panel that is given from the software. When we run in your computer, that will give the output. And that output will have to obtain in the form of a graph. And if you can see here, the set value is given in the left side and the measured value is given in the right side. So set value is your 60%, you can see directly all these squares in the form of a square and the form of impulse is given. And the measured value, you can see, it is just touch. And there is an overshoot. You can see at 60%, if you can see, and it is moving above. The measured value is above that. So in that case, there is more oscillation, and here there is more error. But if you, after that, you can see, the measured value and set value will be very close to each other, so error is minimized. But again, after a certain time, so it is a number of samples you have taken, 687, so number samples in this case, this set value is in the form of square, set value and reference measured value is this. So we have to set the KP value, or KD value, your KI, or KP, KTI and KT, and to obtain the result. So you can change your sample division value, and set value and measured value from graph 1, and then left side will be left thick value will be set value. Another is a right and thin value is a measured value. Bujhela nahi? Hello? All to understand?
Yes, sir.
Tenu tumme eta dekho tike video ta. Eta ame sab set kariba. Measured value dekho. Eta hi palela. ଏଇଟା ଆମେ ସେଟ୍ କରୁଛନ୍ତି ଏଇଠି ଟିକେ ରଖିଲେ ମ୍ୟାଡ଼ାମ୍ ପଜ୍ କଲେ ପଜ୍ କର ସେଇ ପଳେଇଲା ବ୍ୟାକ୍ କର So if you see, there is an integral time constant Ti, derivative time constant Td. We have to change the lower limit, upper limit also we can change. Sampling time, because we have to take number of samples. So a particular time slot, so we have to collect all number of samples. So you can take your sampling time and proportional band. You can see what is the proportional band. You can obtain the Kp value. And the lower limit is 0, upper limit is 100. And also you can get the Kd value. And the Kd is 10, set point value is 32. We have to use the PID action in the reverse mode as connected. And then the graph. After taking this value, you can say the measured value is 39.683 and shared value is 40. So there, that means error is minimized around 0.3 something. And so you can eliminate the error completely and give you 100% performance, better performance, improved performance. But you can minimize and by using the suitable value of Kp or in the form of a proportional band, Ti is the time constant, integral time constant, derivative time constant. Video time. So this is the graph. The measured value and shared value is very close to each other, and the thick line if you see here now, the thick line is basically your set one value, and thin line is basically the in the form of some impulse or some in the some cases there is some impulses that will gives your measured value. Now we can change the set value and take the measured value. So settling time, the last case you can see that it takes the much more time. So settling time is more to set the output value to the reference value. So settling time is more as compared to first case. So now we can change it to 50, 50 set point, your measured value is 49.58. So now you can see the control valve just coming down. Dekhibarla nahi? Hello? Hello? Control valve dekhila nahi? Dekho. Control valve sab dekhibarla? Opening thila aur button closing hoji. It's a panel connection to the output. Control valve will operate either open or close. The compressor is red color. The water is the polish of the set point change color. It is 30 years of the course, so differential pressure sensing will be the mixture of the voltage and DPM. If you have 50 in the last point, 50% touch. বুঝে হচ্ছে না নাই সেট ভ্যালু মেজার ভ্যালু আসছে ইউ হ্যাভ টু ভ্যারি প্রত্যেক তো ডিফারেন্ট রেটিং অ্যান্ড ইউ হ্যাভ টু চুজ আ পার্টিকুলার ভ্যালু ফর উইচ ইউ গেট আ বেটার রেসপন্স বেটার রেসপন্স মিন স্টেডি স্টেট এরর ইজ এলিমিনেটেড অ্যান্ড ইট ইম্প্রুভ দ্য স্পিড অফ দ্য রেসপন্স অর ট্যানজেন্ট রেসপন্স সো অল ইফ ইউ আন্ডারস্ট্যান্ড আই থিঙ্ক দ্যাট অ্যান্ড সো দিস ইজ অল অ্যাবাউট হোয়াট ইউ হ্যাভ ডিসকাসড about the block diagram of flow process and the different elements involved in the flow process. Then we discuss about the characteristic property depending upon the set point and measure value, how will you set the P, K, T, I, K, D to get a better response. I think all of you have understand. If you have any doubt, you can ask regarding this experiment. Because it's not possible to directly take the reading with using that equipment. So we are just exploring and elaborating everything if possible. If you doubt, you can ask, otherwise you go through the theory. But it's not possible to physically you can realize, because this is all online procedure. So I've taken the video for just for understanding. Hello. So anyone can, any problem you can there, you can ask question regarding this. All of you understand the block diagram?
Yes, sir.
All of you? Okay.
Yes, sir.
Okay, actually this block diagram will be same whether we are implementing the level controller or pressure controller or temperature controller. Most probably both are will same. The difference is that the sensing element that we are using for measurement purpose. Like temperature sensing, we can use thermometer, thermometer ball, or RTD, or we can use for pressure sensors, manometer or barometer type, like that. So it will be only changes the sensing, but the overall process control diagram will be remain the same, and we can use the control valve or like that. Overall, both will be same. This is the same main block diagram that will be used whether we are using the controlling of the level or temperature or pressure. Mostly it will be the same block diagram. So if you don't understand this block diagram, what are the elements involved, what the functions of each, and what is the range. So range is already selected, 4 to 20 milliampere, that is 0 to 5 volt, or 3 to 15 psi. That is industry they are using, this is the range. Accordingly, they have designed. There is a proportionally corresponding analog voltage with the corresponding current is the analogous to corresponding pressure, corresponding analog to current that is the corresponding voltage 0 to 5 volt. So this is the range already predefined. So the total voltage or current or pressure within that range. So anyone any doubt regarding this experiment?
Sir, you video to share kar de.
Ha, madam will share video share over. Okay, so madam will take discussion so that if possible then to share the video. Dekhiye kon hoche madam jodi dekhe madam.
Actually, the video is of 200 MB, so it is very difficult for me to share you in the midst of it. I'll try to share you in the Google Drive, okay?
Yes,
I'll share you the link. Okay, thank you. If any doubts, you can ask. And the rest of the, your flow control manual that I have already shared, and block diagram and your panel kit. I have already shared, and regarding the output, I will share it in the form of a Word file so that you can, it will be easier for you to understand, okay? Including all the different parts of the diagram and your graph. I will share it in the Word file, okay?
Ma'am, Chinmay has some doubt, ma'am.
Yes, Chinmay, you can ask.
Hello.
Yes, sir.
Chinmay, can you hear us, Chinmay? Chinmay, can you unmute? Yes. Yes, Chinmay, you can ask. What is your question? those who have not written their name and registration number, you please write down your name and registration in the chat box. Okay, everyone, those who have not written their name and registration number, write down your name and registration in the chat box. Immediately, please, speak fast. Because only 2 to 3 minutes left, so that I can have the college supposed to be open offline classes. No idea, Chinma. Most probably only it is open for the final year students. And maybe after the Dasera, maybe. We suppose so. Let's hope for the best. Because in the middle of the September, it is going to be very bleak again for the children. From 0 years to 18 or 20 years. So depending upon the situation of the COVID, then the close is going to open. So in that case only we will need to have the class on the online mode. So if you have come for the offline classes, then you will be able to perform all the lab experiments by yourself. So that will be easier for you. But still then we are trying our best to make you understand on the online mode. And I will definitely going to share you the video in Google Drive, because it is memory is very, very high. So 200 MB is very difficult for me to send in WhatsApp. But what is the related document, I have already shared in the WhatsApp group. This is only government is going to say about this. We don't have any, till now we don't have any information regarding opening of your third year secondary students. Only we have got information for only final year BTech students, not even for the NTech students. So we have to wait for the decision of the government till September 1st. After that, we get the fresh information of the government regarding the opening of the college or again setting down the college. Okay, I think you're going to have the class, so I'll take your attendance, then you all can leave the group. Okay? Just wait for 1 minute. I'm going to take your attendance.
I will also show me the response of your lagging network. Whether it will be a bandpass filter or band stop filter, I want to check. And from that, we have to find out the lower cutoff frequency, higher cutoff frequency. And then we can get your cutoff with FC. Okay, FC, that is your FL effect. You show me in the next slide. I will see.
Okay, you do in the both the process. Whatever the you had done, that is different, but you have to find out the value of R1 and R2, and putting that value, you can directly find out the equation of GCS, and you have to plot the Bode plot of that GCS. Okay, no need to go for GS or anything else, or the convolution of GS and G1, that is not required. Only go for GCS. Okay, find out the values of each and every one, everything, and then alpha, beta, and R1, R2, then you can go for the GCS equation, transfer function. So, I will going to